Yeah, you know, look, I've when I took over this, I mentioned to you guys how proud I was of this group and how they've handled adversity, how they've stuck together. That clubhouse is phenomenal. I care about them, I trust them, and I think that grows even more after today. No, I mean, look, you play eight games in a matter of a week against the same team. You know, things like this happen. I mean, the scheduling, you know, tensions just, you know, that's baseball sometimes. Unfortunately, there's some ugly incidences once in a while, and I think that's just what happened today. I mean, I know I've known Jesse, have a lot of respect for him and his game, and, you know, he got hit with a pitch, so he was understandably upset, you know, yeah, it was a discussion. I mean, there was nothing physical there, and you know, we had he said some things to me, and I mentioned some things back to him, and, you know, it was nothing more than that. Like I said, I respect what Jesse does with his game and how he plays, and you know, that was about it.
A lot of times these incidents happen and everyone comes out and kind of talks to each other and then that's it. Obviously there's a lot more emotion going on here. Do you think part of that is just where you guys are as a team and that frustration?
Well, I mean, like I said, eight games in a matter of, 10 days against the same team or however many it was. You know, these things happen. You see it happen in the minor leagues a lot. You know, they're playing these six-game series now, and we get to, you know, you're against somebody for that long, and that many, and we have, you know, several more with them this year. I just think, you know, that kind of plays a big part in this. You know, because a lot of things happen during the course of a game where one team has an idea about what the other's doing, and, you know, like I said, I think this is a culmination of so many games in the same week against a division rival. So.
What do you think of Suarez?
He was outstanding. You know, he pitched great last week, attacked the strike zone. He's not afraid. You know, to me, that's just a gutsy performance. These guys handle left-handers pretty well. And he was really good today. I was happy for him. He's such a competitor and a great guy to go out there and perform like that. You know, like I said, he's pitched out of the pen before, and that was the idea there. And nothing fazed him. You know, after what had happened earlier, and to come in there and give us a six, I believe, was outstanding.
And then you talked a lot recently about the people at bat.
Right, he's been taking great swings really the last 2 weeks, 2-3 weeks, and love the way he's playing some second base too. He played some shortstop today and made a couple plays. But no, he's been really swinging the bat well. He's had a lot of hard outs too. Really good approach. What he's done is he's controlled the strike zone better than he ever has in his career, and I think you're seeing the results of that. Yeah, he tightened up right after, what was it, the third or fourth inning. He's had this happen to him before, so come in and evaluate him tomorrow and see how he is. I mean, he was moving around okay after he came out.
When he threw the bubble gun in the sunflower seed, was that in reaction to getting injected, or was that before he went
and
injected?
Yeah, I had just told him that he was ejected from the game and he was upset he was ejected. So and that was his reaction. It happened. I just told him and he went and, you know, he wanted to pitch today. He really wanted to get in the game and he understood where our bullpen was. I only had, obviously you saw how it ended with Ortega. It was incredible. But you know, Iggy wanted to pitch today, and I think that was that frustration.
Mike Iguodala mentioned that you've been in bigger role back in '98 when you were a player against the Royals. Did that role today bring up any like similar sentiments, similar like feelings, memories from that kind of?
No, I mean, you know, I've been a part of. I mean, not necessarily like you know, me starting him. I mean, not in particular instance. Yeah, I'd gotten hit twice and I went to the mound, but yeah, that was, geez, 24 years ago. So, no, not really. It just, you know, I've been a part of a few of these things. I'm sure everybody in these, both of these rooms have, and I mean, you know, they're probably the dialogue a little bit, but no, I didn't even really think about that, to be honest with you.
Most times those type of skirmishes end up a whole lot of really nothing. Were you surprised how intense this one got into?
Well, you're right with that. Yeah, it just escalated, and not sure how, but sometimes they do happen like this. And it is unfortunate it happened today. It's one of those things that once in a while happen in baseball. So. Huge. I mean, really, the first inning he pitched, the eighth, was, I mean, that was electric. I don't think he threw more than eight or nine pitches in that inning. It was certainly really fresh going back out for the ninth. I thought Ray and Maddie in the dugout made a great call to send him back out. And he, you know, after the single, Stass with a big throw, Wader did a great job keeping the tag on. And then Ortega's pitches after that. He went down to work on a couple of things last two weeks, and you know, you're seeing the results of that. A guy that has pitching with a little more confidence today and getting a role like that, I think it'd be huge for him.
The highlights, of course, are going to probably leave with the skirmish, but how about the comeback win in the late innings to be able to rally against a good pitcher in a game that you probably really need?
No, I mean, I know what the narrative of this game is and everything, and you know, pardon the pun, but the fight in these guys really the last few nights has been outstanding. And to come back against the pitchers like that, Marco was great. Munoz has had our number here. He came in the other night and punched out some guys. And McKinnon's had just incredible at-bats against really, really tough pitchers. And you know, it just kind of all came together. But one thing that goes unnoticed, Monty does a great job of getting home. He noticed that throw coming to third, and you see him kick it into another gear, slides into home, and that's the difference in the game, is he gets there before Mike was tagged out at third.